subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello students, you have learned that some fibers are obtained from plants. You also learned that wool and silk fibers are obtained from animals. Wool is obtained from the fleece of sheep or yak, and silk comes from the cocoon of silk moth. Do you know that? Which part of the sheep's body held wool? Are you aware that how these fiber are converted into woolen yarn? We buy from the market and knit into sweaters. Do you have any idea how silk fiber made into silk, which is woven into sarees? In this chapter, we shall try to find all the answers of these questions. So let's start chapter 3 from Science of Standard 7th. The first topic of this chapter is animal fibers. The first is the wool. Wool comes from sheep, goat, yak and some other animals. These wool-yielding animals bear hair on their body. Hair trap a lot of air. Air is a poor conductor of heat, so hair keeps these animals warm. Wool is derived from these hairy fibers. The hairy skin of the sheep has two types of fibers, that from its fleece. Number one is the coarse beard hair, and second one the fine soft under hair close to the skin. The fine hair provides the fiber for making wool. Some breeds of sheep possesses only fine under hair. Their parents are especially chosen to give birth to sheep which have only soft under hair. This process of selecting parents for obtaining a special character in their offspring, such as soft under hair in the sheep, is termed selective breeding. Now, next topic is the animal that held wools. Several breeds of sheep are found in different parts of our country. However, the fleece of sheep is not the only source of wool. Yak wool is common in Tibet and Ladakh. Mohair is obtained from Angora goats, found in hilly regions such as Jammu and Kashmir. Wool is also obtained from goat hair. The under fur of Kashmiri goat is soft. It is woven into fine shawls called pashmina shawls. The fur on the body of camels is also used as wool. Llama and alpaca found in South America also held wools. Now look at your screen. In this slide, I will show you the different types of animals that they held wools. In first figure, we will show the figure of llama and alpaca. We know that these types of llama and alpaca found in South America. The second is Angora goat and goat. These goats are found in hilly area like Jammu and Kashmir. Third is yak. This is common in Tibet and Ladakh. And last one is the camel hair, also used as wools. Now come to the next point, from fibers to wool. For obtaining wool, sheep are reared, their hair is cut and proceed into wool. So how they rear and breeding of sheep? Sheep are reared in many parts of our country for wool. Look at the slide. In this table, I will show the different kinds of breed found in India and the different states of our country and the quality of their wools. The first one is Lohi. This is the name of breed. This breed is found in Rajasthan and Punjab. Their wool quality is good. Second is Rampur Busher. This found in Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, and its wool quality is brown fleece. The third one is Nelly, found in Rajasthan, Haryana, and Punjab. Its wool as a carpet wool. Bhakarwal, it's found in Jammu and Kashmir. Its wool is used for woolen shawls. Marwari, it's found in Gujarat. Its wool is coarse wool. Patanwadi, it's also found in Gujarat. Its wool quality for hosiery. Now, how they rear and breed the sheep? Certain breed of sheep have thick coat of hair on their body which yield good quality wood in large quantities. As mentioned earlier, these sheep are selective breed with one parent being a sheep of good breed. Once the reared sheep have developed a thick growth of hair, hair is saved off for getting wool. The wool which is used for knitting sweaters or for weaving shawls is the finished product of a long process which involves the following steps. The process fibers into wools. The step 1 is the fleece of the sheep along with a thin hair of skin is removed from its body. This process is called shearing. Machines similar to those used by barbers are used to shave off hair usually. Hair are removed during the hot weather. Now the second step is the sheared skin with hair is thoroughly washed in tanks to remove grease, dust and dirt. This is called scouring. Nowadays, scouring is done by machines. Third step is after scouring, sorting is done. The hairy skin is sent to a factory where hair of different textures are separated or sorted. The meaning of sorting is the different variety are separated. This is called the sorted. Now next step, the small fluffy fibers called burrs are picked out from the hair. These are the same burrs which sometimes appear on your sweaters. The fibers can be dyed in various colors as the natural fleece of sheep and goats is black, brown or white. The fibers are straightened, combed and rolled into yarn. The longer fibers are made into wool for sweaters and the shorter fibers are spun and woven into woolen cloths. All these process of fiber into wool can be represented as follows. This is the very short method to represent the whole process. First is shearing. After shearing, start scouring, and then finish the process of scouring, start sorting, then cleaning of burrs, after that dyeing, and finish the dyeing, they roll out all the. Now look at the slide. In this slide we will show all the process of fiber into wool in that pictures. The first picture is so a shearing a sheep. The second is scouring in tanks. It means washing the skin with hairs in these tanks to remove grease, dust and dirt. Third image show the scouring. In this picture show the scouring by machines. The scouring is also done by hands, but today's the scouring by machines. The last picture shows the rolling into yarn. All the process after completing the yarn is rolled out.